In the field of mobile navigation research, path planning is one of the most important problems that is widely discussed by a number of researchers. So in this video, you will learn the role of meta-heuristic algorithms in mobile robot path planning. We have a number of questions covered in this video, like what is robot path planning? How to do proper path planning for a mobile robot? How to find out the shortest path for a mobile robot from source to destination? And important criteria in path planning algorithms, type of environment, type of path planning algorithms, and widely used path planning algorithms for the robot path planning, and how to improve robot path planning. So first question is, what is robot path planning? Path planning is also known as motion planning or navigation. So our aim is here to find the shortest path that is safe and valid for a mobile robot to move from source to destination. In case of human beings, as humans grow with their age, they become smarter, their knowledge increase, they learn from experience, and they can face the different problems in the environment. But in case of a robot, we have no age, so we need certain machine learning algorithms for the training so that they can face the environment. For example, an adult human can easily cross the obstacles. Without any problem, he can reach from source to destination. But in this case, we have a mobile robot, and if there is no proper training, then the result is this one. So our aim is here to find out the shortest path that is safe and obstacle free, so that our mobile robot can easily travel the distance from source to destination without any problem. Next question is, robot path planning can be done in advance? Yes or no? Answer is no, because global environment information is not always available. For example, in case one, we have a robot, and in this case, we have poor robot path planning. Robot don't know where destination is. In case two, you can see here, again we have a robot. And in this case, robot is trained with certain moves and moves are fixed. You can see here, it reached from source to destination by fixed moves. Now in case 3, when you will use this robot in another room, here we have room 2, this robot is trained with fixed move, but this time we have destination here, not here, but our robot is trained with fixed moves, so it is impossible to reach destination. Now question is, how to solve this? So how to do proper path planning for a robot? Answer is, design a proper algorithm. A proper algorithm design contains sequence of actions. Here, you can see here, robot moves are fixed, but a proper algorithm design contains sequence of actions to maintain the robot movements from the source to destination. And here, we are using several intermediate stages to find out the shortest path from source to destination. In short, we can use optimization algorithm to find out the optimum path from the source to destination, and this includes sequence of actions, or you can say several intermediate stages that we will discuss in the upcoming slides. Now next question is, how decision in path planning algorithm selected? Answer is, according to the available information in the current path. So here we have no fixed moves for the robot. So robot will move according to the information that is available in the current path. Next question is how to find out the shortest path. Answer is robot can find out many paths between source and destination, but not all paths are best. Here you can see we have source and destination, and robot can find a number of paths from source to destination, but you can see we have here obstacles, and we need a shortest route that is collision free and obstacles free. In this case, robot can also follow this path, but this one is the longest route. We need shortest path that is obstacles free. So question is here how we can find out the shortest path. For this, we have important criteria in the path planning algorithms. First is optimization, accuracy, completeness, and precision. Now first is optimization goals in path planning. So what is the role of optimization in the robot path planning? First, selected path must be shortest path. Suppose we get the optimum path among all, so that path should be the shortest path without any obstacle, and it should be collision free, and this path should take the shortest time to reach the destination. Accuracy, that should be accurate, and completeness, the proper algorithm design provide all the solution for the best path. It means all the necessary appropriate stages and all the important information. The next question is type of environment in the path planning. Two types of environment in path planning. First is static environment. Second is dynamic environment. In static environment, obstacles do not exchange their position with time. It means obstacles are fixed in static environment. In dynamic environment, obstacles change their position with time. It means obstacles are not fixed. So we have two types of environment that should be considered in path planning. Next is types of path planning algorithms. We have two types of algorithms used for the path planning. First is global path planning, that is also known as offline algorithm. Second is local path planning, that is also known as online algorithms. So here you can see we have two types of path planning algorithm, global path planning and local path planning. In global path planning, environment is static and global information is known, but this is expensive in implementation. In case of local path planning, environment is dynamic and robot have no information about the environment. In the global path planning, information is known, but in case of local path planning, robot have no information about the environment. If robot have no information about the environment, so how robot will move from source to destination? So answer is local path planning algorithm depends on the information generated by the sensors during the movement of the robot. And here these algorithms are more complicated in design, but they are most popular and widely used in robot path planning as compared to global path planning techniques. Next question is different path planning algorithms. We have a number of algorithms here. You can see cell decomposition technique, potential field, roadmap approaches, but we have a drawback for these algorithms. They are inefficient, they provide inaccurate result, and they are time consuming. Now, what's the solution for this? Solution is, we have widely used path planning algorithms, that is heuristic methodologies, nature inspired algorithms, or you can say meta heuristic algorithms, neural system, or fuzzy controllers. Instead of these algorithms, these algorithms are most popular and widely accepted by a number of researchers in the mobile robot path planning. Now, next question is different approaches that we can use to solve single or multiple objective path planning problems for a robot. In the previous video, we discussed define multi-objective optimization problem, where designer want to optimize two or more than two objective functions simultaneously is known as multi-objective problems. What are the different approaches that we can use to solve multi or single objective path planning problems for the robots? Answer is nature-inspired algorithms, neural networks, and fuzzy logic. Meta-heuristic algorithms are nature-inspired algorithms. These algorithms are inspired by nature. Now we have a list of popular algorithms that are used in multi or single objective path planning problems for the robots. In an ant colony, optimization is used to solve path planning problem for the complex environment. BAT algorithm, PSO algorithm, whale optimization algorithm, artificial immune system. These algorithms are widely used to solve different path planning problems for the robots. Now, last question is how to improve robot path planning. Answer is by hybridization of different meta-heuristic algorithm. As we all know, hybridization means concept of mixing. So here what we can mix, so we can mix here different meta-heuristic algorithms. How? By combining the advantages of each algorithm for improved solution. So we can combine the advantages of different algorithm for solution improvement. For example, we can combine genetic algorithm advantages with particle swarm optimization, ant colony optimization algorithm advantages with BAT algorithm, and cuckoo search algorithm advantages with BAT algorithm to improve the robot path planning. So that's all about this video. In next video, we will learn how we can solve robot path planning problem with an example. If you have any question, you can comment below, and thanks for watching this video.